My name is Dr. Jennifer Zeligs, and I am the Director of Training and Research for a special program here at Cal State Universities, which functions like a teaching aquarium for students from all over the world to come and learn about how to use animal behavior modification to take the best possible care of animals and work with them in zoo and aquarium environments as well as in research facilities.
So, and you're writing a book because you're an expert in the field. What was that book?
It's called Animal Training 101, The Complete and Practical Guide to the Art and Science of Behavior Modification. And I hope it'll be a good guide for people who are interested in animal training and behavior in general.
Wonderful. So do you use the ABCs of operant conditioning in your work?
Yeah, so the ABCs of operant conditioning is one of the classic ways that people explain the idea of how behavior is developed. And A stands for antecedent, B behavior, and C consequences. This is the method by which behavior is created, whether I'm doing it intentionally or whether it's happening on its own in the natural world. The antecedent to trained behavior is a cue. The antecedent in the process of training is usually a type of conditioning technique that you'd use. For example, you'll see us using targets. This is a thing that we can use to cause and create the behavior that we then want to see, which is the B. And then the C, the consequence, is the reward, the reinforcement that influences the animal to want to do that behavior again in the future. Another type of consequence can be a punisher. So there's two types of there's actually three types of consequences. Reinforcer, which increases the frequency of the behavior. Neutral, which does nothing to the frequency of behavior. And punisher, which decreases the frequency of behavior.